How many thousands of people?
They don't notice, and they searched every vehicle that comes to the campus. That's why they were getting arrested, they didn't want it in there.
How many thousands of people showed up?
They had 15,000 a day, give or take, some day tickets were after that.
So you got 40 arrests out of 15,000 a day. Y'all shut it down, y'all didn't want to check anymore?
No, they checked everybody.
And once they got into the campground, they're not allowed to leave again.
What happens, Terry, how does that compare to a Ren Fest event in terms of number of drug arrests versus attendance? I mean, I have no way to judge that number. I mean, it was
obviously, it was significantly higher because at a Ren Fest event, most concert events, you don't have, by the way, I'm Travis Bryan, the marketing director for the festival. At most concert events, you don't have the type of intense security that you have at something like this. For instance, let me give you an example. There was a concert, 2013, I think it was, I just saw the numbers on it. There were 55 arrests, 44 people sent to the hospital for alcohol-related illness, one reported rape of a minor. That was at a Keith Urban concert. So, unfortunately, there's a percentage of people that when they come to these things, they think it's their right to party however they want to party. But most concerts that you go to don't have the level of security enforced up front that an environment like this does, because of those, they know that it tends to attract an unwanted element. And I can promise you that every one of those people was searched every time they went into the festival grounds. If they were camping, they were not allowed to leave the campground in their vehicle unless they wanted to pay another $300 or more for an additional camping sticker. So once they were in, they were in.
But Terry, I have a question. You're saying there's only 40 or 50 calls coming into you. How come the Grimes County Sheriff reports that
the call,
911 goes to the Grimes County before it comes to you? Okay, Grimes County Sheriff Department reports overwhelmed the 911 system, and they were afraid they weren't going to get services in the north end of the county because the 911 system was overwhelmed. But you're stating there was only 40 calls that came into you.
To our hotline, that's the only one I know.
Okay, to a hotline. I'm talking to the 911 service. I mean, I'm not calling the hotline. If I got a call from police, I'm going to call 911.
Was there ever any bricks of cocaine when you lived there?
I have no idea.
One thing that I had to bring to the attention of the Sheriff's Department, I called first and got their non-emergency number. Tie up the 911 system, please. It was the non-emergency number. The number they gave out to me was not correct. And I'm afraid some little teenage girl got an earful on her voicemail twice because she called me back the next day and asked me why I called. It was the wrong number the Sheriff's Department was giving out.
I went
to Facebook then and told the Sheriff's Department, because I did a little searching in on the Middlelands Facebook site and all the time, the right number. And then some had emailed and gave that bit to the Sheriff's Department on Friday morning because this little girl.
I assure everybody here that we are part of this community. We participate in this community. We're leaders in this community. We're on City Council, on Eastern City Council. We're on the Chamber of Commerce in this community and the community county communities. Your voice is heard. You'll be pleased with the results.
I have another question. What about all the marketing that you're doing? Why was it not marketed to all the homeowners in the surrounding areas? We had no idea what was going on until we heard the racket.
We had two large community meetings with homeowner associations. Some of them are here in the room.
Yeah, but a lot of us don't belong to them.
But they were supposed to go back to their communities and reports because they didn't want to have a 302.
We don't have one right there. We're right behind the Renaissance on 302.
We voted for a year in advance.
Never saw it until Thursday. Until Thursday at 2 o'clock.
Everything was done to try to promote that this event was coming.
Well, I drive right past you every day. Never knew about it. There's no signs, nothing.
It was at the gas station in the days.
Because
Don't know what it is.
Yeah, they have the billboard.
We're trying to tell everybody as many avenues as we can.
What else is there?
We're not your target.
And they didn't advertise on any radio because they didn't need to. They're bad too.
What about the noise ordinance? Any other place you go to, Woodlands, they have a noise ordinance. They shut down 11.